Asia, the wife of Fir'aun. Asia had all what a worldly woman would want. A woman whose concern is this dunya would want wealth, would want a very comfortable living, would want to have a rich and powerful husband, would want to have servants, would want to have power. She had it all. Asia was willing to give up all of this for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put her in a place, in a palace that was the best in the world. She said, "Oh Allah, I want a house in Jannah."
وَضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا امْرَأَةَ فِرْعَوْنَ إِذْ قَالَتْ رَبِّ ابْنِ لِي عِندَكَ بَيْتًا فِي الْجَنَّةِ.
عندما تعودين إلى المدينة لا تكلمي منهم أحدا.
إنني أنا المسيح عبد الله.
نسوة الكبرى خديجة.
Say Khadija was an old woman. She was a widow. She had children, and then the Prophet married her. I put a question mark to that. Some of our great historians, like Sayyid Razawi, who's written a book, Khadijatul Kubra, when I personally asked him this question, he says, I highly doubt that she was ever married. Her nature and her quality was too supreme, just like Maryam, that no man could get near her. And it didn't come later when she married the Holy Prophet that she became enlightened. Oh no. She must have been a special woman, for through her progeny comes the woman who is the mother of all the imams, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through Jibreel says, Hum Fatimatu wa abuha wa ba'luha wa banuha. She was a very enterprising woman, Khuwaylid. Her father was a very wealthy man, and she comes from the same generation as the Holy Prophet. Their ancestry touches through Qusay. Qusay was the great grandfather of the Holy Prophet, and her grandfather was also Qusay. And from him, the branches Abdul Manaf and Abdul Uzza, you find comes down as Khadija and the Holy Prophet. And the two actually become married. You find that Khadija alayhi salam was a very enterprising woman. When her father passed away, her father left many siblings. She was one of them. Many children. She was one of them. But she was extraordinarily smart. Very sharp woman. very kind and very elegant in nature. Historians have written, even Orientalists have written, that she was an elegant woman, a woman filled with elegance in her. She was not your normal woman. Khadija alayhi salam was so wealthy. When she inherited from her father, all her sisters and brothers inherited, but they all abused their wealth. She was smart. She invested. She must have been brilliant to be able to maintain her dignity, her quality, yet maintaining an enterprising. People say, was Khadija a Muslimah? Let me give you a little historical background. All the Banu Hashim were Muslims. Abu Talib, Abdul Muttalib, all of them were Hanif and Musliman, but they were silent. They were Imams of the time. So Khadija alayhi salam was a Muslimah, but a silent Muslim, waiting to receive the revelation from Allah to complete the deen. Just like the Holy Prophet was born a Muslim, a prophet.
عن خطاها لن نزول ذكرنا يا فاطمة فخرنا يا فاطمة ذكرنا يا فاطمة فخرنا فاطمة نحن أبناء البتول عن خطاها لن نزول نحن أبناء البتول عن خطاها لن نزول ذكرنا يا فاطمة فخرنا يا فاطمة ذكرنا يا فاطمة 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 يا فاطمة فاطمة يا فاطمة فاطمة يا فاطمة
راحتكم راحتكم يا هيمكم يا راح روحي اليوم انا يا معلي تظلون امانه راح روحي اليوم انا يا معلي تظلون امانه راحتكم راحتكم ارفع ايدك حبيبي راحتكم راحتكم لك يا هو يمكم يا هو يمكم راح روحي اليوم انا يا معلي تظلون امانه راح روحي اليوم انا يا معلي تظلون امانه راحتكم يا هو يمكم راحتكم